So very good afternoon, students. Hope all of you are doing good and following the topics. So today in this session I am going to start the new chapter, that is linear equations into variables, chapter 4 of 9th standard CBSE, linear equations in two variables. We are going to discuss this chapter today, chapter 4 of class 9th standard CBSE. So try to concentrate. What is a linear equation? A linear equation is an equation which contains only one variable or two variables or three variables, which should not have any powers. That means, which should have degree 1. That means, they should have x, y, z like that. There should not be x square, y square, z square or 1 by x or 1 by y like this. These are, we should not take. Okay. They should be like this, x, y, z, 2x plus 3 equal to 0 is a linear equation. Y minus 4 equal to 0 is a linear equation. Like this, this is a linear equation in one variable. This is also linear equation in one variable. But in this, these linear equations in one variables you have seen in 7th standard and 6th standard. Very simple equations you have solved. Now, what is a linear equation in two variables? Means the first degree equation involving two variables is called linear equation in two variables. That means, example, I can give x plus y is equal to 4. Otherwise, y is equal to 4x minus 3. One more equation I can write, x is equal to 2y plus 1, x plus y is equal to 5 by 2. These are all linear equations in two variables exactly present, x and y are there. So, these are some examples of linear equations in two variables. So, that means from this you can generalize the linear equation in two variables using generalization. This is the general form of linear equation in two variables, which is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Here a is not equal to 0 or b is not equal to 0. If both are equal to 0, what happened? We write c equal to 0. If there is no variable, then how can you say this is a linear equation? That is why either a not equal to 0, either a not equal to 0 or b not equal to 0, then that is called linear equation in two variables, right. That is called linear equation, I can say, because if there is no variables, you cannot say that is a linear equation, because linear equation should have the first degree. There is a note, ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is a linear equation in two variables x and y. That means, this is general form of linear equation in two variables x and y. Now, that means, they give different equations to you to express them in ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Like for example, write each of the following equations as ax plus by plus c equal to 0 and hence indicate the values a, b, c. Like very first question, x plus 5 is equal to root 3y, another y minus 3 equal to x, then another 3x is equal to 5, then another 2x is equal to y. Let us see how we do it. X plus 5 is equal to root 3y. Bring root 3y to the left hand side. So, x plus 5 minus root 3y equal to 0. Our format is ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So, then first x, then next y, next constant, arrange. Okay. X minus root 3y plus 5 equal to 0, and compare this one with ax plus by plus c equal to 0. A is the x coefficient, b is the y coefficient, c is the constant. X coefficient nothing is there, means 1. Y coefficient is minus root 3. Constant is root 5. Next question, y minus 3 is equal to x. So, bring x on left side, y minus 3 minus x equal to 0. So, arrange them in ax plus by plus c format, first x, next y, next constant. X is having minus, so minus x plus y minus 3 equal to 0. So, from that compare with ax plus by plus c, you get a is minus 1, b is plus 1, c is minus 3. Similar way you can do the other question, 3x is equal to 5. What is this? 3x is equal to 5. So, 3x minus 5 equal to 0. Here there is no y. So, right, see when it is, there is no variable present over there, one variable is not present over there, write like this, 3x plus 0 into y is minus 5 equal to 0. Since y is not there, that is why it is 0 into y. Then immediately compare, a is 3, b is 0, c is minus 5 from this. 2x is equal to y, so 2x minus y equal to 0. Here the problem constant is missing. So, constant is 0, a is 2, b is minus 1. Next, write each of the following equations as equations into variables x and y. Here x is equal to 5 is equation 1 variable, but they are asking us to write an equation in 2 variables. How to write equation in 2 variables? X is equal to 5, then x minus 5 equal to 0. What is not there here? Y is not there. So, just write it as x plus 0 into y minus 5 equal to 0, since y is not there. So, it is equation in 2 variable. Next, 2y is equal to 3. So, 2y minus 3 equal to 0. Here x is not there. Write 0 into x, then others as it is equal to 0. 3x is equal to 4. Here y is not there. 0 into y. So, these are the in general form as well as in 2 variables x and y. When one variable equation is given, what is two variable, how to express means like this we can express. So, based on this knowledge you try exercise 4.1, try yourself. I will be sharing the solutions to you for your revising only. Whatever the printed solutions I am sending you, you can use them as reference. First you try yourself, and if you are getting any doubts or for reference, we wanted to see the answer, means you see the answer, go through the answer, how they have done, see the solution, then try to do yourself. Okay, the reference material, printed material which I am sending you, that is for reference only. It is, you do not copy as it is. Okay. Next, solution of linear equation in 2 variables. The values of x and y which satisfies the equation ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is called the solution of linear equation. It is denoted by x comma y. What is that? Once again, solution means what? The values of x and y which satisfies the equation ax plus by plus c equal to 0 is called the solution of linear equation. It is denoted by ordered pair x comma y, which was learnt in coordinate geometry. So, it is a point. Solution is a point in the Cartesian plane. So, it is a point. Solution is a point of point which satisfies this ax plus by plus c equal to 0. So, let me take an example. See, x plus y is equal to 4. You can give an example. 1 comma 3 is a solution as 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. 2 comma 2 is the solution as 2 plus 2 is equal to 4. You can give 5 comma minus 1 is a solution as 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. You can tell 100 comma minus 96 is also a solution. What is that? Because 100 minus 96 is 4, right? Like that many solutions are there. That means from this, what do you understand? Linear equation in 2 variables has infinitely many solutions are there. It has many, many solutions. Okay. So, from this solution of linear equation, you have it is infinite number of solutions. How many solutions are the linear equation in 2 variables can have infinite solutions. So, they are asking one question to find out 4 solutions of this equation x plus y is equal to 7. Sum of 2 numbers which is equal to 7, any 2 numbers you can take, sum of 2 numbers which is equal to 7. So, any 2 numbers they said, that means I can take 1 6, 2 7, 2 5, 3 4. 10 minus 3, 11 minus 4, like that any, I gave randomly some examples here. So, you can give any example like that, so that sum is 7. Like this we can give many such, that is why linear equation has infinitely many solutions. So, whichever the examples I give, not only this examples, you can give any example. For example, I can give x plus y is equal to 7, see, what is the equation? X plus y is equal to 7, see, I can give 7 by 2 plus 1 by 2, 7 by 2 plus 7 by 2, wait, it is 17 by 2 minus 3 by 2, how much it is? 14 by 2, which is equal to 7. That means, you can say that 17 by 2 comma 3 minus 3 by 2 is also a solution. Like that infinite solutions you can give, many solutions you can give for the linear equation in 2 variables. Like for example, one more you can give. What is that one more? I can tell 0 7 is also a solution. 0 plus 7 is equal to 7. 7 0 is a solution. as this is very simple equation, this is a very simple equation, we can randomly find out like this. Sometimes the equation will go complex, that time how to find out the solution. Equation may be complex sometimes, that time how to find out the solution. For that, we use the process of finding the solution of linear equation in two variables. The process is, write the given equations in the form of y is equal to mx plus c format first. Then substitute the different x values to get different y values. If I explain one example, you will understand. First of all, writing the given equation in the form of y equal to mx plus c, then substitute x values in this to get y values. Okay. Substitute x values in this to get y values. If you put x is equal to some value, you get y value. Okay. So, then like that, how many x you substitute, that many y you get. So, write all the solutions in the form of x comma y format, that is called solution. Okay. Now, let us see one example for doing these three steps. Find any two solutions of 2 x plus 3 y equal to 7. Very first, you write 2 x plus 3 y equal to 7. 3y is equal to minus 2x plus 7, because 2x is going that side is minus 2x, and then y is equal to minus 2x plus 7 whole divided by 3. So, then we wrote y equal to in terms of x expressed. So, then take x value 1, any value x equal to 0, 1, 2, anything you can take, I took 1. X equal to 1, if I substitute in this, minus 2 into 1 is minus 2 plus 7 by 3, which is 5 by 3. X is equal to 2, when I take, is minus 4 plus 7 by 3 is 3 by 3 is equal to 1. That means, when I take x is equal to 1, y is 5 by 3, x is equal to 2, y is 1. So, substitute x, y, x, y, 1, 5 by 3, 2, 1 are the required solutions. They ask for two solutions, we found two solutions. If they ask three solutions, you take x is equal to 3 and substitute. If they ask three solutions, one more value take, x equal to 3 or x equal to 0, like that, anything. Substitute x to get y value. Okay. Now, one more example. Check whether 3, 7 is a solution of this or not. When they ask you to check whether the solution or this one or not, what you do? 3, 7 means take x, y. X equal to 3, y equal to 7, substitute in the equation given, 4 into 3 minus 2 into 7 plus 2, because x is 3, y is 7, 12 minus 14, 2, because 4, 3 is 12, 2, 7 are 14 and 2, 12 plus 2, 14, minus 14, 0, hence 0 we got it with. 3 comma 7 is a solution. Do you understand? Hope you got it. So, with this knowledge you can do up to exercise 4.1 and 4.2, you can try yourself. Maximum you try exercise 4.1 and 4.2. So, please try to do exercise 4.1 and exercise 4.2 as homework by next class when I start. These two must be completed by you. Okay, the solutions will be shared through WhatsApp to you, the solutions, refer the reference, the chapter 4 solutions I will send this time before only. So, for your reference I will send, you just go through the solutions, and please do exercise 4.1 and 4.2 after listening to this video, after revising this PDF everything. Okay, thank you very much everyone, wish you all the best, good luck, and take precautions for this also, stay home, stay safe. Thank you very much.